Come on. You know what time it is?
You know how cold it is?
Come on. Look, kid, I'm late. I really am.
Hey, my roommate's getting up in a few minutes. She gotta be working a half hour. Come on, baby.
Look, I'll see you in a week or two, okay? Maybe after the holidays.
Okay, I'm in, honey. Boy, someday I'm gonna freeze trying to get into this dump. We ought to get that lock fixed or leave the door open. Hey, you know what I saw, honey? Cutest Christmas tree. Real nice. Of course, it wasn't a real Christmas tree, but it had that real nice modern look. Maybe we ought to get one like it. Maybe it wouldn't scare the birds. Well, how'd it go tonight? Same old coffee and pie, slap and tickle truck drivers. Boy, I'm glad it's your turn to open up. I couldn't make it. So how was business tonight? Anybody interesting come in? Norma, come on. It's your morning to open up. Norma, wake up! Norma? Norma, honey?
Oh! You officers sure are cautious. Fellow has a little trouble. You got to check his whole history?
Nothing personal, sir. Just part of the job.
You think I'd stolen that car or something?
Didn't take us long to check.
You didn't.
Turn it up.
This is Tri-State Transmission. The following Wisconsin and Illinois officers will report to Tri-State Control for briefing on extra duty assignment tonight on Tri-State Tollway. E. Waters. M. Mishavimi. R. Eggenweiler. J. Ritterbush.
I wonder what that means.
Who knows? I'm glad it's not us. I promised the kids we'd pick up a Christmas tree tonight.
Here's Richardson's.
Hey, Cal. That's Cal Richardson, the tall guy. Now, he's a good mechanic, and he's got a tow truck.
Oh, thanks. Right. Thanks a lot.
It's 475, Cal.
Yeah. You, Cal Richardson?
Yep. What can I do for you?
Those police officers told me you could fix me up with a ride to Chicago. How about it, mister? You going into Chicago?
Nope. Joliet.
Well, hey, how about a lift to Joliet?
Now, Joliet ain't hardly Chicago, is it, mister?
Well, I could get a bus ride from there. Anyhow, it beats standing around here in the cold.
Okay, hop in. I'll be leaving in a minute.
Much obliged. Thanks.
Once a state line has been...
Maybe I'll bring you a little present. We'll hold the convoy at an even 55 and maintain a position in lane 3. Now look out for anybody that tries to get alongside of that convoy, tag it, and maintain a similar speed. Dan McVeigh, he'll go ahead and brief the toll plazas and also act as a roving field representative.
This is Mr. Ziegler.
He's in complete charge of the security of this convoy.
I'll stick around here and coordinate.
Now, is that clear? All right, boys, I guess that's just...
I'd like to add one thing, Harry.
Well, go right ahead, Mister.
I know you're all curious about this. Let me just say that even I don't know the exact nature of this convoy. I do know this. I know it involves the future of every American. It's out of my jurisdiction.
Thank you,
Commissioner. Thanks very much. We've got an awful lot to do, boys. Let's get right at it, huh?
Thanks,
Miller. Well, you got it all clear?
Five girls murdered. All by the same guy. Now, that much we know. Uh-huh. And nothing else to go on. I mean, it doesn't make any sense.
Yes, I know, but what about the convoy?
Yeah, everything is clear.
McVeigh, some facts of life. There's nothing we can do about Georgie Porgy until he makes a mistake. But there's everything we can do about the convoy.
You understand?
Suppose he doesn't make a mistake.
Something special this evening. But Denise, baby, it's all yours.